South Africa High Commissioner to Uganda, Major General retired Professor Lekoa Selemolo, says Uganda and South Africa's relationship has been shaped by history. He was among South African troops who participated in Uganda's liberation struggle in the mid-1980s.
But the relationship of South Africa and Uganda were born in trenches of battle through sweat and blood. Many perished to have this relationship. When it was not fashionable, this country took in South Africans' liberation, and I was amongst them. He was in the world in those places. So, there is no way you can talk of the history of South Africa, a free South Africa, without mentioning Uganda.
With the elimination or easing of travel requirements, especially to South Africa, the two countries will benefit from the arrangement.
Today, what is on the table, I'm one of those champions that says we need a visa-free travel between Uganda and South Africa. And that drive, the request, that thing is already being discussed at that highest level. Because the histories of these two countries are not histories or relations that were born in boardrooms with memorandums of understanding.
He was meeting top executive Ugandan women drawn from different facets, including media, tourism, education and medicine, who have just returned from a 10-day experiential tour of South Africa.
We were challenged with the fact that culture, which is really something that we have a large history in as Uganda, was well documented and used to brand South Africa.
So that the Bene could be like any other, ethnic group along Uganda, but they are producing such quality products depicting their culture, their heritage, and they are now at the forefront of South Africa's tourism.
The Women of Substance trip, facilitated by the South African Airways in partnership with South African Tourism Board, seeks to nurture links between Uganda and South Africa. Dennis Igoa for UBC Business.